Good morning. In the previous lecture, we discussed library functions. The next article is arithmetic statements. Arithmetic statements in Fortran. What is use of these arithmetic statements in Fortran? Arithmetic statements in Fortran are used to evaluate a valid expression in Fortran. Arithmetic statements are used to evaluate a valid Fortran expression, and the format for arithmetic statements in Fortran is format of arithmetic statement in Fortran is variable is equal to expression. LHS is any single variable. LHS of this format is any single numeric variable. Maybe integer variable, maybe real variable. Expression, it should be valid expression, valid Fortran expression. Between the single numerical variable and this arithmetic expression, we put a symbol. This symbol is equal to sign. This is equal to symbol. It means that Fortran evaluates this expression and the result obtained will be given to this variable. So, whenever we go for arithmetic statements, we have to remember two things. What first thing? First thing is Fortran evaluates this expression, this arithmetic expression. Second thing, result of evaluation of this arithmetic expression is given to this numeric variable. We can have many examples for this. For example, I is equal to 2 plus a to the power 5. Of course, you have to provide value of a in the program. When this statement is encountered by the control, it supplies here value of a, the calculation is done and result is stored in the memory location named variable I. What is variable? Variable is name given to memory location of the memory of a computer. Here for simplicity, let us suppose that value of a provided in the program is 5. value of A provided in this program is 2. Then this will be 2 plus 2 to the power 5. How many times? 5 times. 2 twos are 4, 4 twos are 8, 8 twos are 16, 16 twos are 32. So 2 to the power 5 is 32. 2 plus 32, 34. This 34 is stored at the memory location whose name is I. When we are working with these arithmetic statements with such a format, we found that there are 4 different types of arithmetic statements. Let us study these 4 different types of arithmetic statements. Let us go to the first one. The first type of arithmetic statement is integer variable is equal to integer expression. First type of arithmetic statement is integer variable is equal to integer expression. What does this mean? It means that whatever expression present here, that expression is evaluated. Actually, this expression is integer expression. What is integer expression? We already studied. Integer expression is consisting of only integer constants and integer variables. Integer expression consists of only integer variables and integer constants. So, such an integer expression is evaluated by the computer. The result obtained will be an integer, and that result will be stored at the memory location whose name is integer variable. For example, J integer variable, I, J, K, L, M, N are by default integer variables. A defined integer, B defined integer. Declaration of A and B variables here is integer. This expression is integer expression. Let us solve the values. Let us solve this expression. This will be evaluated by the computer, and what will be that? For A, I have to put 2 plus 2 to the power 3 plus 3
into 2, that is equal to 2 plus.
What are precedence rules? Hierarchy of operations. If bracket is there, we have to first evaluate the bracketed terms. After that, we have to go for exponentiation. After exponentiation, we have to go for multiplication or division. And finally, for addition or subtraction. So, let me put the addition as it is. Let me first solve, let me first evaluate this one, 2 to the power 3. 2 into 2 into 2, 3 times. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, plus 3 into 2. Now, this multiplication needs to be done. 2 plus 8 plus 3, 2s are 6. This is equal to 16. This is example of the arithmetic statement of first type, integer variable is equal to integer expression. We can have many more such examples, provided that we have to keep this format. This format is for first type of arithmetic statement. Now, let me go for second type of arithmetic statement. Integer variable is equal to real expression. Second type of arithmetic statement is integer variable is equal to real expression. What is meaning of this? The variable declared is integer variable. The expression is not integer expression. The expression is a real expression. Real expression, real arithmetic expression, which consists of real constants and real variables. So, this expression will be consisting of real variables and real constants. When the computer evaluates this expression, result will be a real number, a real constant. Result will be a real constant. As this is a second type of arithmetic statement, the computer does truncation. Truncation, only integer part of this result is stored in this memory location named integer variable. The fractional part of the result will be omitted automatically by the computer when we use this type of arithmetic statement in our program. This is second type of arithmetic statement whose format is integer variable is equal to real expression. Let us have example of this. In the first one, okay. In addition to ijkl mn, if a is declared in the program as integer, a can be integer variable. If b is declared as integer, it can be real, it can be integer variable. That concept I have used in the earlier example. Remember this thing. Okay, now let me go for this thing. And let me change the equation. Now you will find that this is integer variable, this is a real expression, because A is real, B is real, and therefore this expression is a real expression, whereas variable on LHS is integer. When the computer evaluates this, the evaluation will be this way: 2.5 plus 3.0 to the power 2 plus 3.0 into 2.5. This is equal to 2.5 plus exponential will be first evaluated. Exponentiation will be first evaluated. 3 to the power 2, it will be 9.0. 3 is real, so its square will be real. Plus, this has second priority, so let me put as it is in the second step, and then let me evaluate this. 2.5 plus 9.0 plus 25, 3 is a 75, that is 7.5. Do the addition. 7.5 plus 2.5, that will be 10, 10 plus 9, 19.0. But when this value is stored in the memory location J, the value stored will be 19. 19.0 will not be stored because 19.0 is real, whereas 19 is integer. Real expression evaluated, the result obtained will be real. Truncation is done. Here in the fractional part, 0 is coming. Instead of 0, here the part coming may be 1, 2, 3, 4, any numeral. In that case also, the fractional part is truncated, omitted by the computer, and only integral part of this result is stored in the memory location named J, where J is integer variable. This is second type of arithmetic statement, right? Now let us go to the third type. Real variable is equal to real expression. What is meaning of this? Meaning of this format is, the variable or LHS of the format is a real variable. It is not integer variable. So we have to declare that this variable is a real variable with the word real at the beginning of the program. To the RHS of this format, the expression is a real expression, real arithmetic expression. Real arithmetic expression is consisting of real constants and real variables. The result may be a real constant. The real constant is stored in the memory location, which is named as a real variable. Real value is given to a real variable. This is third category or third type of arithmetic statements. Here you can have the same example. Instead of J, let me take C here. C here. 19.0 as it is given to this variable. Variable C is real variable. It is not integer variable. So you may consider the same example for the थर्ड टाइप और थर्ड कैटेगरी ऑफ अरिथमेटिक स्टेटमेंट्स. द फोर्थ कैटेगरी ऑफ अरिथमेटिक स्टेटमेंट्स इज रियल वेरिएबल इज इक्वल टू इंटेजर एक्सप्रेशन. द फोर्थ कैटेगरी ऑफ arithmetic statements is real variable is equal to integer expression, meaning that in this format LHS is a real variable. The variable is already declared as real, right? And on RHS of this format we have integer arithmetic expression. It is consisting of only integer variables and integer constants. The computer, the control, the editor will evaluate this integer expression, and the result obtained will be integer constant. But when this result is given to the real variable, the integer constant is converted to real constant, and then it is given to the real variable. For example, now I is real integer variable, j is integer variable, their values are declared here. Values assigned to I and j here are 4 and 6, both are integers. C, it is the real variable. Expression is the integer expression. The computer will solve this way. 4 to the power 2 plus 6 to the power 2 minus 2 into 4 minus 3 into 6. Exponential will be done first. 4 to the power 2, 4 into 4, 4 for the 16 plus 6 to the power 2, 6 6 is 36 minus 2 into 4 minus 3 into 6, 16 plus 36 minus 2 into 4, 8 minus 3 into 6, 3 6 is 18. This is for the 6 plus 6, 12, 2, carry 1, 5, 52 minus 26, 8 plus 8, 16, carry 1, 2, so 52 minus 26, and that will be what? Just 26. The result is integer, as the expression is integer expression, the result is integer. But when it is given to this variable, which is a real variable, what given is 26.0. We will not get this result. Instead, we will get this result in the memory location named C, which is a real variable. This is about the arithmetic statements which are of four different types. The general format was given already at the beginning of this article, and its four types are also discussed along with the proper examples. So this is about the arithmetic statements in Fortran. The next article is structure of Fortran program. We shall discuss this article in the coming lecture. Thank you.